Hello YouTube, my name is Julian Pesnicka for Not a Picture. This video is going to be an extended look at creating this particle simulation, which frequently scales up and sorts its elements within the animation. This effect is loosely inspired by the Half-Life Alyx's visual effects. We show the GeoNode setup as well as the Fusion effects chain to add depth of field and motion blur in post. First, we establish the basic GeoNode setup in Blender by adding a plane and then a grid node which gets values for the size and for the vertex count. In this case, we want the area to be square, therefore we use each input for the X and Y dimensions accordingly. This plane will be the spawn area for each particle. Then we add a mesh to points node to visualize the loose elements which we transform in the next steps. We change the movement with a set position node by connecting the scale value mentioned before to the offset input. Between these values, we establish the math to animate the particles randomly between each integer scaling step. So, on every integer value, the particles were sorted, but in between these integer values, we get a randomized movement. Let's tackle the randomization first and add a noise texture and a position node. Then we add a vector math node and limit the movement to the X and Y values. Then we add a second math node to control the power the noise has over the animation itself. Now we can change the value number with a math node set to ping pong and 0.5 to get a number over 1 if the input scale value is not an integer and 0 if it is. Now the animation scales randomly, but on every integer scale the elements are sorted correctly. In the next steps, we'll limit the animation part to only certain elements and let the selection circle around each time the scale value exceeds an integer, so that on every scaling up, different elements will animate. The selection method we are using now uses a repeat zone as its base, which outputs multiple values based on the scaling that we use as the selection input for the set position node. So in the repeat zone we need a boolean value, which we use as the selection, and an integer value to change the randomized seed of the selection every time the scale exceeds an integer. First we connect the boolean values in the zones and connect the repeat zone's output boolean to the set position node's selection input. Then we add a boolean math node set to R, a compare node and a random value node. Then we compare the random result with the index node by the compare node. We limit the max value by the multiplication of the vertex numbers which were set before. To change the random value node seed, add a math node with a summation of an integer value. Then we add the math node's output to the ID and seed input of the random value node. And now we have the basic setup for the particle effect. The next steps will depend on your project's needs and will vary. For example, we added an instance on points node to spawn cubes on each particle. These cubes are animated separate from the simulation to get this specific look. So now we are happy with our simulation. To add certain effects in post, we have to prepare our Blender scene so we output more information than the standard rendered image we see now. In this case, we need a Z-pass to output each pixel's depth in Z-space to calculate a bokeh effect in post. And we need the motion vector path to add motion blur in post as well. We render each path as an individual OpenXR image sequence, so we have a clear separation later in Fusion Studio. Speaking of it, after rendering, we import all the sequences into Fusion Studio. Then we add an OCIO display LUT so we can see the right color space and transform. We add the same color config file we used in Blender, which is in this case the ACES config file. Then we add a vector blur node to mimic the blur which happens on fast objects filmed with a real camera. For that we add the rendered motion vector path image sequence to the vector path input, so the node can change the pixels based on the speed information of the motion vector path. And then we add a Bokeh Pro plugin to emulate the bokeh effect of a real camera. We add the depth path and invert the input of it. We change the blur and the distance, so we can have only a certain part in focus. In the next video we'll explore such post-processing more in depth. Please like the video and subscribe to this channel for more interesting tutorials.